Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about incremental load with insert and update. If you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video before going forward, where you can understand what is incremental load and why it's required. Go to on SSMS, and here as we can see, this is our source table and this is our destination table, and these two tables are available inside our SS Unitech database. So what our plan? Our plan is I want to load data from the source table to our destination table in incremented base. So initially we don't have any data in our destination table, so in our source table we have 10 rows. Once our package will be executed, then all these 10 rows will move to our destination table. Then destination table would have 10 rows. Then if we insert new records in source table, once our package will be executed one more time, then it will load only those records which is newly updated in our source table, and these 10 rows will not going to move in our destination table because those rows will be already available in our destination table. So how we can achieve this? Go to on SSDT. And here I would like to add one more package. This time call this package as incremental load. Looks good. Now I would like to use a data flow task. Then double click on this data flow task. So here we want to load data from SQL Server table. So we need to use OLEDB source, and we want to load data into SQL Server table. So again we need to use OLEDB destination. So as of now, as we can see, we are having these two tables inside this SS Unitech database. In real time, these two source and destination table may be available in different databases or different SQL servers. As of now, for demo purpose, I have created these two tables inside this single database. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to create two connection managers, first for the source and second for the destination. Click on new, and here we need to select the server name. So this is our server name. We can select and go to on databases, and here I would like to use SS Unitech. So this is our database. Now click on OK, then again OK. So this is for the source. So we can rename our connection manager with source. Then I would like to create one more connection manager, and this time for the destination. So as we are having same SQL Server database, so I gonna use that one. Click on OK, and I wish to rename with destination. Now double click on this OLEDB source. So here I would like to select our connection manager, that is source. Now click on OK. In our tables, I would like to use employee source table. That is fine. So we are having 10 rows. Looks good. Go to on columns. So I am happy all these columns. Now click on OK. So we have done our source. So between source and destination, I want to use lookup transformation to check the data is available in our destination table or not. So we can connect with lookup, then double click on this lookup transformation, and here I gonna use OLEDB connection manager. That is fine, and here we need to specify redirect rows to no match output if data will not match with our source table with our destination table. Then go to on connection. We want to make connection with destination. That is fine. Then we can check our destination table. Looks good. We can preview, and we are not having any data right now. We can close it. Go to on columns. So here we need to look up on the behalf of employee ID, so we can connect with employee ID. That is fine. Now click on OK. Then I need to connect with destination, and this time I am very happy to use no match output. If data will not going to match with our destination table, only then we want to load data into the destination. Now we can double click on this LADB destination, and here I just want to load data in employee destination table. Go to on mapping. So mapping succeed. As we can see, available input columns and available destination columns are same. That's why mapping succeed. But in our destination we are having is deleted column. As we can see, in case of is deleted, then we can see the design. In design, as we can see, is deleted, default value is 0. If we are not going to specify any value in this deleted column, then it would accept 0. So as we can see, data type, it's bit, so it would accept 0 and 1, true and false. So go to on SSDT and click on OK. So we have done our package. Now save this package and execute our package. So package executed successfully and 10 rows should be inserted in our destination table. Stop this package, and here this is our destination table. So we can refresh this table by pressing Ctrl R. So we are getting 1 to 10. So now I just want to insert some record on this table. So I gonna use ID 11, then ID 12 as well, and so this is ID 12. So once our package will be executed one more time, then 11 and 12 will be inserted in our destination table. So go to on SSDT and execute our package. So package executed successfully, and here as we can see, we are getting 12 rows, but after lookup transformation we are having only 2 rows, and 2 rows will move to our destination. Now stop this package and go to on SSDT, and in our destination table I would like to press Ctrl R to refresh this table, and we are having 11 and 12. So here we have discussed how we can incremental load insert. Next I would like to discuss about update. So in case of update, as we can see here, we are having ID 4 with Rajesh. So I gonna use Gupta in our source, then Manish, so I gonna use Singh. So once our package will be executed next time, then these two rows should be updated. So how we can implement, go to on SSDT, and here I would like to use OLEDB command. So we can drag and drop OLEDB command, and we need to connect lookup transformation with match output to OLEDB command. Now double click on this OLEDB command, and here I would like to specify connection manager. So destination, that is fine. Go to on component properties. So here we need to specify our SQL query. So I just want to update our destination table, so we can write update emp destination table. Then I wanna set emp name with anything, next salary with anything, and department ID with anything. That is fine. And here I would like to use where condition, where emp id is equals to anything. That looks good. Click on OK. Now go to on column mapping. So inside this column mapping, we need to map our parameter columns. So our first column is employee name, I guess. That is fine. Then salary, then department id, and last column is employee ID. So that is fine. Now click on OK and save our package. So once our package will be executed, then inside this LADB destination we will not get anything, because there is no any new row available in our source table. Those are not available in destination table. But we have two rows which is updated in our source table. First for ID 4 with Rajesh Gupta, and for ID 9 is Manish Singh. In our destination we are having Rajesh and Manish. So execute our package and check our output. So click on start. So package executed successfully. Stop this package and go to on SSMS. And this time I would like to refresh this table. So as we can see, we are having Rajesh Gupta and Manish Singh. These two rows have been updated. So I hope you have understand how we can use increment and insert and update. In our next video, we will discuss about how we can handle with incremental delete. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.